You said 16,000 CDs, man. How much of that back then was a bootlegging problem? Back then, wasn't no bootleg. Yeah. Oh, okay, bad. What? Nigga.
Hey, I seen the video. Let rap a lot. Somebody catch you bootlegging a Scarface CD or something back in the day. Them niggas used to beat bootlegging.
Yeah, we pulling up.
It wasn't that bad.
Yeah, we pulling up.
The bootlegging really got bad once the mixtape started.
Hey, I remember I was listening to a CD. It was like, man, if you ride with a nigga right now and that nigga got a bootleg, then you say, pop that bitch out. If that bitch ain't got no CD cover, fuck with a fake ass nigga, man.
It was bootleg movies for CDs. You know what I'm saying? Them niggas whoop your ass. Here go a funny story.
Yeah.
We at a gas station. Guess what city we in?
Dallas, Texas.
the nigga say, hey man, I got these CDs. I said, what you got?
Yeah.
The nigga go the name and everything. I said, nigga, you ain't got no EZ. He said, shit, nigga, I got all three. I said, same. Tip me. I swear to God.
I got all three though.
I say, tip me. He said, what you mean? I say, nigga, look. Oh man. The nigga gave me like a $40-$50 tip. I swear to God.
Was he a good salesman?
the nigga felt bad in the motherfucker. He was like, man, damn, dog.
Nigga, man.
Cause I did it in a comedic way. I ain't do it like nigga. I'm just like,
percentage, my nigga, percentage. Yeah, it's a percentage game, for real. Man, hey, man. R.I.P. Screw, man. My thought process for you was when you came in the game and, you know, with the Screw, the freestyles, did you feel it was going to go as far as it did, like, coming in the game?
Say, seventh grade, my outfit for the talent show was an LL Cool J outfit. I never forget. I went to a little cheap-ass Bill's Dollar Store, but I had a real red Kango. My uncle had bread. He got me a real red Kango. I went there, I bought a shirt. That bitch was like $7. It had Animal on it. I still remember. My uncle, he was an engineer. That nigga had sent me some burgundy and white Patrick Ewing's for school. That's the outfit I wore. I felt like I could be them niggas. It was never no limit. I swear to God. That's what I felt like. 7th grade, 8th grade, 9th grade. By the time I'm in the 12th grade, you bet not be a rapper 60 mile radius. They coming to get me. Everybody. They like, hey. I had a fucked up nickname. My nickname was Snap. That was my mama's name. So, that was my nickname, Snapper. So, since I used to rap, they used to, like, fuck them names, Snapper the Rapper. Yeah. That's how I came up with ESG. When I'm in Lafayette College, I said, I gotta have a rap. I ain't gonna tell nobody my name is Snapper when I go to college, right? So, nigga, I said, what describes me? Everyday street gangster at the time. That's how I come with that. I always had the vision that we could do it. So, when I went to Screw House, I remember the first Screw tape. Me and the Botany Boys. Shout out to Botany Boys. Real OG niggas at the time. They hadn't seen a nigga that could do what I do. So one of them niggas was like, man, this nigga be hogging the mic. You know, because at that time, I got a million raps in my head. I'm rapping about everything. You know, I just walk outside. I rap about every car, all this shit. And, you know, they just fucked their head up. So, you know, at Screw House, it's so crazy. We was youngsters. You know, everybody had their own dreams and vision. I still remember when Stick One pulled up, Lil Kiki got out the van, they were like, that's Lil Kiki, that nigga hard. Boom. Pokey mostly came around right when I got locked up. So I got locked up in 9-5. You know what I'm saying? So, but like Grace, R.I.P. Grace, Los and Grace was there. Ronnie Spencer had a long ass Jerry curl. You know what I'm saying? I was like, who that nigga? That nigga sang. Boom. They got this fat nigga that go to Ye sing. That's Big Mo. Boom. So many people used to come there. So we would be there. I told Big Hawk, when Big Hawk really started rapping, true story. I tell the story all the time. I said, say, man, because it's so vivid in my mind. I said, say, bro, you know, I do this rap shit to get some money. We can get paid rapping. I was like, man, I'm just doing this shit for fun. That's what niggas did at Screw House, you know, and shit. You know, history is history. You know, once we started really putting the shit out, niggas took it serious. You know, but I always thought we could make it, bro.
Yeah. One more history fact. You did mention you was locked up in 9-5, right? Bun B mentions you on the song, Diamonds and Wood. Peace to ESG.
1993. I'm in Lafayette. Yeah. And the DJ like this club Strawberries. They don't let just any nigga grab the mic. Cash, like Badass, all these new people, you know, that's what Mystical, all these, so UGK got a concert there.
Yeah.
The promoter and the DJ say, man, we want you to meet UGK. Then a long old school Lincoln white limo. Yeah. I get in there, bun on one side, Pimp sitting over there. Pimp had like an ounce of Reggie back then. That's when they used to smoke Reggie. Yeah, yeah, yeah. With a little bit of, with a little bit ass 380 sitting right there. Yeah, they listen. So I get in the limo. They're like, hey man, this ESG. I said, what's up? So this Pimp exact words. So you wanna be a rapper, little nigga? I'm like, yeah, bro. He say shit. You know, he just gave me some encouraging words. All I tell you is, you know, keep doing what you're doing, da 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 da. Cause you know, we both kind of had like a light ass voice. You know what I'm saying? So all my OG niggas, they banging, tell me something good and all this. So this right after that, it's like when Swinging and Banging and all that shit came out. You know what I'm saying? And he got fucked out, locked up. So that's when Bun said my name on Diamonds Against the Wood.
Yeah. Yeah, first time I heard Swinging and Banging, man, Greg Street played it.
Yeah,
Greg Street, he was out here.
You better holler at me, man. I see you had, you know what I'm saying, smack, well, get us up there. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, Greg Street, OG.
Shout out Real Street Stars, nigga. Moving. Hey.